Hello everyone, this is Sarita, working as assistant professor in the department of ECE, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. So today's session I am going to explain about SONET or SDH. So what is meant by SONET? It is a synchronous optical network. And SDH is nothing but synchronous digital hierarchy. So here, with the use of the synchronous optical network, we can increase the data rate and bandwidth capabilities also increases. So in our telecommunication worldwide, with the use of this SONET and SDH, we can increase the data rates in our telecommunication. So SONET stands for synchronous optical network. SONET is a communication protocol. So it is developed by a biller that is used to transmit a large amount of data over a single channel. So we can transmit the large amount of data and long distance using a optical fiber. Here the optical fiber is the channel. So when we are transmitting the information from source to destination, we need optical network. So for that case, we are using synchronous optical network and synchronous digital hierarchy. So with the use of SONET, multiple digital data streams are transferred at the same time over the optical fiber. So why SONET is called a synchronous network means, in that synchronization is nothing but when we are transmitting the information from source to destination, here sender and receiver both are having same clock pulse. Both are using single clock pulse. So it is nothing but synchronization, multiple bits. So multiple data signals we are combining with the use of the synchronization, and we can transmit the information with the use of only one optical fiber. So a single clock means it is a PRC, is nothing but primary reference clock, handle the timing of transmission of signals and equipments across the entire network. So this is the structure, network elements. So in this structure we are using STS multiplexer or demultiplexer, and next one is regenerator, add drop multiplexer, regenerator, STS multiplexer, demultiplexer and terminal. So here STS multiplexer and demultiplexer, with the use of this STS terminal, whatever the input signals, here input signals are number of signals, with the use of multiplexer, it multiply the number of signals and transmitted. Here we are using regenerator. What is the use of regenerator? Regenerator is nothing but repeaters. So with the use of this regenerator, we can increase the signal strength. Again, we are using add drop multiplier. Multiplexer. What is the use of this add drop multiplexer? If we require data is there, we are adding the data. If it is not a required data, means we can redirect it without using demultiplexing. So whatever the data, desired data is available, then we can multiply and across the receiver, we can demultiplexing the data. If it is not required, then it is redirected without do the demultiplexing. So for that case, we are using add drop multiplexer. Here, add drop multiplexer. After this add drop multiplexer, we are using regenerator. Again, we are using regenerator. So again, it amplifies the signal. So in this case, in wavelength division multiplexing. So in this we are using, in our optical communication, we are using wavelength division multiplexing. In this wavelength division multiplexing, we are having two types, coarse wavelength division multiplexing and dense wavelength division multiplexing. So when we go for dense wavelength division multiplexing, in this we are using booster amplifier and line amplifier, and last one is post amplifier. So here booster amplifier, line amplifier and post amplifier. This booster amplifier is used across the, it is connected, it is linked across the end of the transmitter. And this line amplifier is connected between the optical fibers. So if we need to increase the data rate, we need to transmit the data for a longer distance. For that case, we are using this line amplifier. Each 80 to 100 kilometer distance of the optical fiber, we are using this line amplifier. So with the use of this line amplifier, we can increase the signal strength. And across the receiver end, we are using post amplifier. So with the use of this booster amplifier, regenerators are nothing but amplifiers or repeaters. With the use of these repeaters, we can increase the signal strength. When we are transmitting the information through the optical fiber, the signal strength is very less. The signal strength is very less means with the use of these regenerators, we can increase that level. And across the demultiplexer end of the receiver also, we are using regenerators. Here, whatever the information we are transmitting across the source and we are receiving across the receiver with the use of demultiplexer. With the use of demultiplexer, it receives the information in single channel, and by demultiplexing, we are having here the signal strength is C1, here it is C2, here C3, here C4. Across input also C1, C2, C3 and C4. So like this, whatever the input we are transmitting and we are receiving across the output, and between that we are using regenerators and add drop multiplexer. And in this network, it provides some optical links. Those optical links are called as section, line, path. So what is mean by section? Section is nothing but it is a optical link provided to the neighboring devices. Here, section is nothing but the connection between STS to regenerator, or regenerator to airdrop multiplexer, airdrop multiplexer to the regenerator, and regenerator to the STS multiplexer or demultiplexer. So line is nothing but it is the optical link provided between STS multiplexer, demultiplexer to the airdrop multiplexer, airdrop multiplexer to the STS multiplexer, demultiplexer, or to STS MUX or DMUX, or to add drop MUX. So this is nothing but line. What about path? Path is nothing but it provides the end to end connection. It provides the path between end to end. STS multiplexer, demultiplexer to the STS multiplexer to the demultiplexer. So here section is nothing but it provides the optical link between neighboring devices, and line is STS to add drop multiplexer, or STS to STS, or add drop multiplexer to the add drop multiplexer. Line is path is nothing but it provides the end to end connection, STS multiplexer to demultiplexer and STS multiplexer to the demultiplexer. So here STS multiplexer. So STS multiplexer performs the multiplexing of signals. It performs the multiplexing of signals, and here STS multiplexer converts the electrical signal to optical signal. So how we can convert the electrical signal to optical signal? In our optical communication, we are using optical sources are LED and laser. With the use of these LEDs and laser, the electric signal is converted into light. Here how it converts electrical signal into light means, here on off pulses. Suppose if you are using LED, so LED on off means if it is on, representing with 1, if bit 0, it is low level. If light is absent, we are representing with 0. If light is present, we are representing with 1. So electrical signal can be converted into light form. And again, a demultiplexer, we are using this light signal into electrical form. For that case, we are using photo detectors. So photo detectors are one is PN photodiode And the second one is PIN photodiode. And third one is avalanche photodiode. So these are the photo detectors, and optical sources are LED and laser. LED and laser. So here STS demultiplexer multiplexing performs the demultiplexing of signals, converts the optical signal to electrical form. For that case, we are using these photodiodes. Regenerators. So with the use of this regenerator, it is a repeater that takes an optical signal and regenerates and increase the signal strength. Add drop multiplexer. What is the use of this add drop multiplexer here? It allows to signals coming from different sources into a given path or remove a signal. If the receiving input is desired input, it is necessary, then we are adding that input. Otherwise, it redirects. So, for that case, we are using add-drop multiplexer. Add-drop multiplexer. Why we are using SONET means it converts the electrical signal into optical signal so that can travel the longer distances. SONET connections. In SONET connections, we are having three types. How it provides the optical link between devices, section, line, path. Section provides the neighboring devices. Line means it provides the optical link between STS multiplexer demultiplexer to the add drop multiplexer, or to STS to STS, or add drop multiplexer to the add drop multiplexer. Path is nothing but end to end portion of the network, end to end portion of the network. And here SONET layers. So how many layers are there? Path layer, line layer, section layer, and photonic layer. Here path layer, line layer, and section layer comes under data link, and physical layer is nothing but photonic layer. So how we can transmit the data? With the use of path, line, and section layer. So line layer, what is the use of this line layer? The data is, the connection is established, the connection is live or not based on this section layer. So line layer, the data is transmitted or not from STS to add drop multiplexer, or STS to STS, or add drop multiplexer to the add drop multiplexer. So path layer is nothing but how the data can be transmitted from source to destination. If you are transmitting the information, if you are receiving or not. So that is nothing but data link layer. Physical is nothing but photonic layer. Here path layer. So path layer is nothing but it is responsible for the movement of signal from its optical source to its optical destination. So path layer is nothing but the connection established from path layer. Path layer provides the optical link between source to the destination, sender to the receiver. Means the responsible of this path layer is movement of signal from its optical source to its optical destination. So STS multiplexer demultiplexer provides path layer functions. And next one, line layer. So line layer, it is the responsible. So line layer, it provides the optical link between the STS to add drop multiplexer, or STS to STS, or add drop multiplexer to add drop multiplexer. So here it is responsible for the movement of signals across a physical line, across a physical line. And STS multiplexer or demultiplexer and add drop multiplexer or demultiplexer provides a line layer functions. And next one is section layer. So section layer, it is the responsible for the movement of signal across the physical section. So it is a section layer is nothing but it provides the optical link between neighboring devices. Means it is responsible for the movement of signals across the physical section. And each device of network provides the section layer functions. And last one is physical layer, path layer. It is corresponding to the photonic layer. It is corresponds to the physical layer of the OSI model, physical layer of the OSI model. Here it includes the physical specification for the optical fiber. Physical specifications for the optical fiber. Physical specifications is nothing but if light is present. Suppose I am sending that if light is present, we are representing with 1. If light is present, we are representing with 1. If light is absent, then we are representing with 0. So, how we can describe this 190 means depending on pulses. 1 means it is high level. 0 means it is low level. For example, if we are considering NRZ. In our digital communication, if you are transmitting the data, we are having different types of issues and different types of techniques are there. Return to zero, non-return to zero, Manchester coding, different types of coding techniques are there. So depending on advantages, depending on specifications, we are using any one of the coding technique. So in this, we are using non-return to zero. In this non-return to zero, if you are using polar or unipolar, we are using if unipolar. So how we can represent the data? So in unipolar NRZ means, suppose my data is 1 0 1 0. 1 means high level, 0 means low level, again 1 means high level, 0 means low level. So like this we are representing the input signal in terms of pulses. If data is present, we are representing with 1, means the voltage level is high. If data is 0, it is in 0 level only, means the voltage level is 0. So like that we are transmitting the information from source to destination, then electrical signal can be converted into light. If light is present, we are representing with 1. If light is absent, we are representing with 0. And what are the advantages of this SONET? So with the use of this SONET, we can transmit the large amount of data and longer distance. Here electromagnetic interference is also very less. So interference is less means here the transmission is we are transmitting information with the use of optical. The channel is optical fiber. So here optical fiber, here this is the basic structure of our optical fiber. So this part we are representing with core, and this one is cladding. This one is cladding. Suppose my information is transmitted within this core only. This core is covered with cladding. So the information is transmitted within the core means it is the total internal reflection. It is the total internal reflection. Means the core is fabricated, the core is made up of with the glass. Then here, the interference is very less and high data rates. Interference is very less means whatever the information we are transmitting and without any loss we are receiving means here noise is less, means data rates are increases, or obviously high data rates and large bandwidth. So these are the advantages of with the use of this SONET. And what is the difference between synchronous transmission and asynchronous transmission? So what is mean by synchronous transmission? In our communication, synchronous and asynchronous both are important terms. Here synchronization is nothing but transmission is the type of transmission. Synchronous transmission is the type of transmission. In this case, we are using single clock pulse per transmitter and receiver. So when we go for asynchronous, there is no need to external clock pulse. Internally, source has its own clock pulse, receiver is also has its own clock pulse here. On other hand, asynchronous transmission is the type of transmission in which the sender and receiver have their own internal clock. So thus do not need any external common clock pulses. When we go for synchronous transmission is the type of transmission in which a common clock pulse is shared between transmitter and receiver in order to permit synchronized communication. And data unit. So in this, how we can transmit the information in synchronous means the data units are frame or block. So when we go for an asynchronous, the data unit a byte or character. In synchronous transmission, data is sent in the form of frames or blocks, so that unit is frame or block. When we go for an asynchronous transmission, on the other hand, in synchronous transmission, data is transmitted in the form of byte or character. So, data unit is byte or character. So, performance and cost efficient. So, due to implementation of common clock pulse in synchronization synchronous transmission, the transmission data rates are high. So, what about cost? Somewhat here in asynchronous transmission, but this makes this transmission costlier. So, in this performance, both the transmitter and receiver both are using single clock pulse. A single clock pulse means here data rates are increased only. So, when we go for asynchronous, in this we are using start and stop bits. So, transmitter has internal clock pulse and receiver is also have internal clock pulse, means the data rates are somewhat lesser than the synchronous transmitter. But compared to synchronous transmitter, asynchronous transmitter is cheaper. So, due to implementation of common clock pulse in synchronous transmission, the transmission of data is faster as compared to that in asynchronous transmission. But this makes this transmission is costlier. So, in asynchronous transmission, on the other hand, each sender and receiver has their own input clocks in asynchronous. Hence, the transmission depends on its synchronization. So, is slower as compared to that in synchronous transmission, but this makes this transmission is cheaper. What is mean by complexity? So, here in a synchronous transmission, we are using single clock pulse, both the transmitter and receiver. Means here the circuit designing is very simple. For example, consider here, this is my clock pulse. This is clock signal. And here my data bits are. So these are my data bits. So in the same clock, I am using for both the transmitter and receiver. But when we go for asynchronous, I am using start bit. And here stop bit. And between these start and stop bits, we are using data bits. So we are transmitting data with start and stop bits. So this is a synchronous and asynchronous transmission. So here complexity, it is easy to design synchronous transmission and asynchronous. However, on the other hand, asynchronous transmission is complexity in nature and design. What about data gap? In our synchronous communication, there is no data gap because we are using only one clock pulse. But when we go for an asynchronous, some data gap is there because of we are using start and stop bits. Here data gap due to the common clock pulse in synchronous transmission, there is no gap present between data. And in our asynchronous transmission, on the other hand, the asynchronous transmission, there is a gap present between the data and consists of start bit and end bit in middle of which actual data is present. Here the data is transmitted, here start bit and stop bit. Between the start and stop bits, actual data is present. So these are the differences between synchronous and asynchronous transmission. Next, what is the difference between SONET and SDH? So here, SONET stands for Synchronous Optical Network, SDH stands for Synchronous Digital Hierarchy. So in SONET, it is a digital hierarchy interface for the optical transmission. It is a network hide interface, user network interface, and your reference point interface to assist BISDN. So here Sonnet is developed by the American National Standard Institute, ANSI. So Sonnet is, it is developed by ANSI, that is American National Standards Institute. And STH, it is developed by ITUT, International Telecommunication Union. So telecommunication standardization sector. So Sonnet here, the total number, it has total number of transports overhead here, 9 × 3, total 27 bytes we are using in our Sonnet. But SDH, it has total transport overhead 9 × 9, it is 81 bytes. Here it can transmit data in only one synchronous mode. Here it can transmit both synchronous mode and asynchronous mode. It does not provide better transmitter rates as compared to the SDH. SDH provides the better transmission compared with the Sonnet. Next, optical networks here, overhead. So what is mean by overhead? So Sonnet overhead is not added as header or trailer. So as we have seen in other protocols, so instead of Sonnet inserts overhead as a variety of locations in the middle of the frame. In this overhead, in this frame structure, we are having total four layers. One is photonic layer, section layer, line layer, and path layer. So this photonic layer is the lowest and performs the physical layer activity. This photonic layer is nothing but, it is the third layer in of OSI model. It is the photonic layer, is the lowest and performs the physical layer activities, while all other three layers correspond to the data link layers. So here data link layers are section layer, path layer, and line layer. So here in this photolink layer includes the physical specifications for the optical fiber channel. Here the sensitivity of the receiver, multiplexing functions, and so on. It uses the NRZ coding. Here NRZ coding is nothing but non-written to zero. For example, 1011, if we are taking unipolar, 1 means high level, 0 means low level, 1 means high level. So this is unipolar. And when we go for bipolar, bipolar NRZ, here my data rates are 1011. For example, here 1 0 means low level, 1 means high level. So like this we are representing unipolar and bipolar NRZ. So section layer and overhead, this layer is responsible for movement of a signals across the physical section. This section layer, it provides the optical link between the neighboring devices. The responsible of this section layer, movement of a signal across the physical layer session. So it handles framing, controlling, scrambling, and further basically this section layer is used to framing and scrambling and error control. So here section overhead, which is added in this layer, contains 9 bytes of the transport overhead accessed, generated, and processed by section terminating equipment. So in this overhead, up to here, in this total we are having 90 columns and 9 rows. Here 90 columns. So 90 columns and 9 rows. Out of these 90 columns, 3 columns are used for transport overhead. 3 columns are used for transport overhead. And 87 columns are used for SPE. So this transport overhead is carried out as section overhead and line overhead. And this SPE is carried out the path overhead. Here in this overhead, this frame starts from A1, A2. Starts with A1, A2. And these three, A1, A2, J0, B1, E1, F1, D1, D2, D3 are comes under section overhead. And here H1, H2, H3, B2, K1, K2, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8, D9, D10, D11, D12, S1 or Z1, M0 or M1 by Z2 and E2. These are comes under line overhead. And path overhead Z1, B3, C2, H4, G1, F2, Z3, Z4, Z5 are path overhead. So what is the function of these section overhead and line overhead? This section overhead and line overhead comes under transport overhead. So here this overhead supports functions such as following: performance monitoring and local order by, so data communication channels to carry information or OAM and P and framing. So framing operates here A1 and A2. So A1, A2, it starts, indicates the beginning, STS1 frame. STS1 frame, here the data rate of STS1 frame is 51.84. It is STS1, it is 51.84. If you are using STS3, then 51.84 into 3. So like this, the data rates are increases based on this STS. Here the frame starts with A1 and A2. So here these two bytes indicates the beginning of an STS1 frame. These are used for framing and synchronization. These bytes are also called alignment bytes. Section trace. So here J0 is a section trace. It is used to allocate connected section to variety, verify. It is used to allow connected section to verify whether the connection is to lie and with the right terminations or not. So with the use of this section trace, if the connection is established, with the use of section layer, it provides the optical link between the neighboring devices. So with the use of this J0, the basic function of this J0 is verify whether the connection is still alive and with the right terminations or not. So this is the function of section trace. And parity bits. So parity B1. So this parity octet is used by the receiver for bit error rate estimation. So here, as this is of 8 bits, 8 parities are calculated. What is mean by parity? Parity is nothing but when we are transmitting the information for secure purpose, we are using this parity. So with the use of different coding techniques are there. So with the use of this parity code, we can secure the information. In that parity, we are having even parity or add parity. If the data is present, suppose 8 bits, in that 8 bits, I am adding one parity bit. So depending on that parity bit, either if I am transmitting even data, across the receiver I am receiving odd data. So depending on the parity bit, if the receiving data is correct or not, so how we can detect the errors across the receiver. So with the use of parity, we can detect and correct the errors across the receiver. So order while, that is even, this is not used today. So this was used to technician to test the system by installation. And section user channel, that is F1. So it is used by the network service provider. To octet is carried over from section to section within the line. So section data communication channels, that are D1, D2, D3. So these octets from a communication channel to send administrative messages. These are considered as a single 192 kilobits per second message. So it is used for maintenance, control, alarm, monitor, administration and the other need for communication between the section terminating equipment. So with the use of this data communication channel, it verifies, it maintains the control, alarm or administration, monitoring, everything is comes under this section data communication channels D1, D2 and D3. Pointers and pointer action. So what is the use of pointer? So if I am pointing in particular memory location, the data is stored in a particular location or not. So with the use of this pointer, it provides the location of the data. So these are used to point to the payload. They provide flags to indicate about changes to payload location and provide location for the data. And line parity B2. B2 is used for bit error rate estimation. Next one, automatic protection switching. So here automatic protection switching, these two octets are used for automatic protection signaling between line level entities. So automatic protection switching stands for, it is APS. And line data communication channels D4 to D12. So D4 to D12 octet for communication channel. So these are basically used for maintenance, controlling, monitoring and administration and alarms. So these communication channels, the responsible for these D4 to D12, these channels are used for maintenance, control, administration, monitoring, alarms, as well as communication need between line terminating entities. And synchronization messaging, that is S1. So it is used for transporting synchronization status messages and is defined for STS1 of STSN signals. So bits 5 to 8 are used for this purpose. And STS1 M0, this active octet send number of errors detected by BOX. So back to transmitter, octets back to the transmitter. So this helps in knowing line status as well as receiver status. So with the use of this M0, we know the line status of the transmitter and receiver. And M1, the function is same as M0. So here with the use of M0, so number of errors detected by B octet back to the transmitter, and M0 and M1 both are used for status of the receiver. And E2 is the function of E1. And here overhead, observe here in this total 90 columns. Out of these 90 columns, EIT7 is used for SE. EIT7 is used for synchronous payload envelope, SPE. And this payload overhead also comes under this SPE only. And remaining three columns are used for transport overhead. Here the frame starts from rows only, so that the frame starts from left to right or top to bottom. Here the frame starts with A1, A2. So frame starts from left to right or top to bottom. Here the payload overhead, the first column is synchronous payload envelope, so is referred to payload overhead. It consists of path trace, that is J1, and path BIP at B3, STS path signal label C2, path status G1, path user channel F2, multi-frame indicator H4, and growth octets Z3 and Z4, and N1 fields. Here path overhead consists of J1, B3, C2, G1, F2, H4, Z3, Z4 and N1. So here J1 is used to verify the connection status live or not and check whether is connected with right termination. So with the use of this J1, it is verify the connection status is live or not. And path BIP at B3. So with the use of this B3, it used to find the bit error rate estimation. It is calculated overall the bits of previous STS SPE before scrambling process. And C2, it indicates the type of traffic carried out in the payload overhead. So part of the SDH frame. And G1 is used for it conveyed by the path terminating status or performance back to the transmitter. And path user channel, it is used for communication similar to the F1 octet in the transport overhead. And multi-frame indicator, it is H4. It provides the generalized multi-frame indicator for the payload. The first purpose of this indicator is for virtual table tree structured payload. VT is nothing but virtual table tree. Here the second purpose is for support. Virtual connections here, STS1, SPS, growth octets, that is Z3 and Z4, reserved for future use. And another one is N1 field. So this octet is used to allocate support for the tandem connection maintenance and tandem connections data link. So in this virtual territories and pointers, these are basically used here. Observe here in this mapping, VT type, bitrate, size of VT. In this 9 rows are common for all the VT1.5, VT2, 3 and 6. Here the data rate, bit data rate megabits per second here, 1.728. In this columns are different. So we are distributing total columns, we are distributing here virtual here 9 rows. Rows are common in our virtual territories. Columns are distributed here. 3 columns for VT1.5. 4 columns for VT2 and 6 columns for VT3 and 12 columns for VT6. Here the bit rates are 1.728 megabits per second and for VT2 2.304 and VT3 3.456 and VT6 here 6.912. So here in virtual territories is a partial payload that can be instead of into an STS1 and combined with other partial payloads to fill out the frame. So instead of using 86 payload columns, so 86 payload columns here, STS1 frame for data from one source. So we can subdivide SPE all each components as a VT. So in this SPE, we are having total 87 columns. That 87 columns we can subdivide it to the virtual territories. So here there are several options for how payloads are actually mapped into the virtual territories. So floating mode mapping, use the pointers to allow the payload to floating within the VT payload. So there are 3 different floating mode mappings. One is asynchronous and bit synchronous and byte synchronous. In this we are having 3 mappings type: synchronous, bit synchronous and byte synchronous. So these are the VT mappings: VT type, VT1.5, VT2, VT3 and VT6. Here the bit rates are for VT1.5 1.728 and VT2 2.304 and VT3 3.456 and VT6 here 6.912. In this case, we are using rows are common. In this, we are having total the frame structure 9 rows and 90 columns. Here, out of this 90 columns, 3 are used for transport overhead and 87 is used for SPE. In that SPE, subdivided into 3 columns for VT1.5, 4 columns for VT2 and 6 columns for VT3 and 12 columns for VT6. So this is the VT mapping of our SONET or SDH. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.